Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome to American Defender. So, for my RC folks out there, have you ever wondered how to hack the Traxxas ID system? I've been sitting here trying to figure it out, and I got it figured out. Okay, right here. There it is. Okay, I bought an Arma. I got my first Arma, and I'm proud of it. I absolutely love it. And, we're going to be doing a lot of videos with this thing. Right there. That is the Arma Infraction 6S. All right, probably the most baddest vehicle out there in the RC world right out of the box. Okay. This thing makes the X01 look like a slash. Okay. It is just... this thing is killer. All right. And we'll go over the features and stuff with that in a separate video, because this thing is just killer, okay? I want to talk about hacking the ID system, though. And this is something that a lot of folks out there, they don't like Traxxas. Traxxas is actually losing customers left and right. They actually are. There's a lot of newbies that come in and buy Traxxas stuff and think, yeah, I got a Traxxas, And I'll give Traxxas their due. Old school Traxxas. Back in the day of the Hawk, when the Rustler first came out, when the Slash first came out, the Bandit, the Stampede, those were all fantastic vehicles the way they were when they originally came out 20-some-odd years ago. Okay. But as time went on, Traxxas got kind of greedy. And so they started making proprietary stuff. Chargers and batteries, most notably. Okay. And they saw a section of the market where they're like, okay, we can dominate on that and kind of pick a corner of that market and make it to where only our stuff works with our stuff. You know what I mean? Only our chargers and stuff will work with our cars. And then they'll sit there and spin you this garbage about, oh, we did it because of safety. No, you did it because of capitalism, which I'm all about capitalism, but yeah, the way you guys are doing this is kind of scammy. Okay, it's kind of a little dishonest. You got to admit it. Got to admit it, Traxxas. I mean, you have a history of doing really dishonest things. You know, putting copyrights and patents on stuff that you had no business on ever patenting. You never invented it. It had been in the market for probably 25, 30 years in some cases. Nobody had ever patented it. And so you went out and said, well, then if you haven't done it, I'm going to do it and profit off of your work. Yes, Traxxas has done that. There's all sorts of stuff on that on the internet. All right. You can read all about it. Lots of lawsuits. Traxxas is constantly suing people, making money that way. They're not really the company side of things is not really as honest as everybody would think. They're kind of scummy, actually. So, and some of their cars are kind of cruddy, like the Fortec and the X01 and all of that. So their trucks are good stuff. Like I said, they're old school stuff, but something happened to Traxxas. They got greedy, all right? So they came out with this Traxxas ID system. They used to run the old school plugs like this. Okay, that was the old school Traxxas plug. Worked fantastically. There were no problems with it. Works great on lipos. Works great on all of the nickel metal hydride stuff that was out at the time. There was not a single problem with this plug. There wasn't one problem. Okay. But Traxxas was like, you know what? You know what we're going to do? We're going to incorporate this entire second plug into our new plug, and we're going to call it an ID system, and we're going to make it to where if you don't use a Traxxas charger, you can't charge your battery. Enter the TRX plug, or what people call the Traxxas ID plug. They're black, they're big, they're ugly, they've got a big bump on the bottom of them. They're completely different than this plug. Now, however, if you have an older battery or an older car, you can still go back and forth with all of this. However, if you have an older Traxxas charger, you're up Poop Creek without a battle. All right, you can't charge that new battery on your older Traxxas charger. So now that they're going to bend you over and make you pay double for a charger so that you can use their equipment. This is why a lot of people that buy Traxxas stuff, the first thing that they do on the car is they ditch the Traxxas plug. They ditch it. All right, they go to an XT60, an XT90, an IC5, an IC3, whatever. Okay, Dean's connector, whatever. They go to something else. Okay, the banana plug, whatever. Because then they don't have to use that Traxxas charge. Right. And I have one sitting over here. I, however, am not in a position to where I can go and change all of my cars over to a new plug and go buy a new charger. I can't do that right now. Right. So I'm stuck using a Traxxas Easy Peak. All right, 2S, 3S, single battery charger. This is the only LiPo charger I have. All right. Now let's talk about the charger. The charger's actually an okay charger. It's an okay charger. It does all the things you would want a charger to do. However, when you buy one of these chargers, brand new, out of the box, and you pull it out and you're looking at it, as an experienced RC person, because most of us don't read the manual, you look at this thing and you're like, where the hell do I put the balance leads? And it's like, where do I put them? And they hide them behind a door. They're right here. They're on the face. They hide them behind a little door and put the word Traxxas over it. Make it look like a little plaque. And they make they form the door in such a manner to make it look like it's just part of the case. So they hide it. They don't want you to know that their ID chargers will charge any battery. You just have to adapt to it, okay? So I just got my infraction, okay? And I need to charge my big-ass 3S batteries that I've got for it. My local hobby shop didn't have any adapters to go from IC5 to Traxxas. They've been out of them for a couple of months. So I'm not going to sit this car around a couple of months. I got videos to make. I've got rubber to burn. I've got stuff to do. So I want to use this car. I need to get used to it because I've got stuff coming up where I'm going to use it. And I happen to have, since I'm switching everything to 3S now, I'm abandoning 2S pretty much. I happen to have a Traxxas ID battery. So I lopped the connector off of it. Now, when you lop a connector off of a LiPo battery, I don't suggest that you do it. But if you do it, do it one wire at a time. Never cut two wires at once on a battery. Ever, ever. And never cut a battery on your... never cut a battery, period. You don't need to cut the battery. Never cut a wire on your car with the battery plugged in. Okay, always unplug that sucker. If you ever on the battery do cut more than one wire at once, you are going to get the nastiest surprise you ever saw in your life, because this battery is going to short circuit right then and there. It's going to puff, it's going to smoke, and catch fire in your hand. So don't do that. Okay, cut them one at a time, and when you're done cutting them, this is just a little extra something I like to do. My cut ends on the battery, I cover them up with black tape. You can use shrink wrap if you want, or whatever you got. I wouldn't suggest wire nuts, but black tape, you know, some shrink wrap, you know, something. Cover them up to where they can't accidentally make a connection to something and short out, okay? So cover them up. And that doesn't mean that the battery's bad. It just means that I'm going to have to cut the case on the battery, get in here and solder in new connectors and a balance connector, and then convert this over to just a regular 2S battery like everybody else uses. But at the same point in time, on a side note, when Traxxas does their balance connectors, it's not the industry standard wiring. They do it all jumbled and backwards and weird. Okay, so they kind of do this crisscross stuff with it, and it's not how the industry standard is. Okay. So I lopped that connector off. I have an IC5 pigtail. Soldered the two together. Used my shrink wrap on there. And then I thought, okay, maybe now that I've cut, because originally my thought was that that wire coming up the side was the ID system. Okay, so I cut that wire. It's no longer here. As a matter of fact, I even cut the connector completely out. All right, the wire and everything completely out of this connector. I don't even want it in there. I don't want a chance of it being in there. Get it out of there. Okay, take this, plug one of my 3S batteries into here. I plug it into this Easy Peak charger. And this thing still recognizes this damn connector as an ID connector. So I thought, okay, well, I'm going to plug my balance leads into here. It's recognizing it. So I'll just plug the balance leads in and plug it in, hit go, and it should charge. Doesn't work that way. Okay. It won't charge it. So I undo it. I'm like, okay. What's going on here? There's got to be some other something making a connection here. There's got to be some kind of something telling it, hey, this is a Traxxas battery. There's got to be some kind of chip built into this plug. And there is. If you notice on the old plugs, they're flat all the way around. And on the new plugs, like I'll show you the other side of a Traxxas plug here to demonstrate this. You'll notice it's got this dip right here. Okay, you got this bump. And on the bottom of here, there's normally a bump right here. That's the chip. Okay, that's the Traxxas ID chip right down in there. So what I did to hack this, to make this work, and I'll prove to you it works here in a second, is I took my little wire clippers, got in here, get kind of right under the chip, right under the bump, level with the rest of the plug, and just slowly kind of nibble into it. Just nibble, nibble, nibble. And you'll have these other two. You've got your two gold-plated plugs up here. These stay there. Okay, these little gold-plated connections, those stay there. You want those. Those are your main feed. Okay. You'll see down underneath here, though, you'll see there's two little stainless connectors. Grab those with your clippers and just rip them out, okay? And then nibble, 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 and you'll see that chip kind of you bite it a little bit, lift, bite it a little bit, lift, and all of a sudden it'll pop right out of there, okay? And the next thing you know, boom, you're back to having just a regular old Traxxas plug. All right. Now they also have, like I mentioned, you have a wire that runs up this side. Well, you also have a wire on some of them that runs up the positive side. And you can kind of see here, you can see the hole right there. So all that has to disappear. Now on the sides right here, you can just clip the wire and leave it there. All right. As long as you get rid of these connectors on the bottom and that chip, that makes this just a regular old Traxxas plug. All right. And then you just, again, solder it here. And I'll show you again that it does work. Okay, so we're going to take this. And some of you might be worried, you know, well, it's exposed on the bottom, it's going to start a fire. No, it's not. Because looking at the bottom of this plug right here, on the charger end, you have the connections that connect up here, and then you have two pins that run up the sides right here, which I believe is what goes into that chip. And then on the bottom, there isn't a single metal anything. All right, so you're perfectly fine. It's perfectly safe. It's just okay. All right, so I'll plug that in right there. Grab our 3S. Looks like we did the last time. Plug this into our 3S balance port. Okay, now you see what it's doing? See how it's tracing up and down? Bing, 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 bing. Okay, what we need to do when it does this is press the start and stop button, and I wish this had a longer cord. They only give you a 2-foot cord on here, which is ridiculous. The charge rate button and your start stop button, hold them both down. Okay. Green lights kick on. You guys can see those green lights. And I see this light's flashing. Your charge rate light's flashing. So you come over here, select whatever charge rate you want, and then hold down the start button. Green light kicks on, and now you're charging. That's how you defeat the ID system. Okay? And ID plugs. That's how you do it. I'm going to stop this because these are charged already. So, all right. So, that's how you defeat it all. Take that. So, you can just leave this in here if you happen to have an armor or whatever. Or make a bunch of these pigtails up. And you're ready to go. All right. Now, again, this was an extenuating circumstance for me. If you can get an adapter that'll work, do it. All right. But I just wanted to show everybody how to defeat that ID system on that battery end plug, because it's only on the battery end. It's not on the speed controller end. Okay. For whatever reason that you would need to do it. That's how you would do it. Little pair of wire nips will do the job perfectly. Okay, these are cheap. You can get these everywhere. These are actually the ones to my Ender. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video. Hopefully it was something that helped somebody out there. I am going to go plug my Arma in now and go run it up and down the street and drive my neighbor's dogs crazy. So with that, thank you for watching. God bless you. Take kid fishing, take kid shooting, and I will see you on the flip. Bye now.